Okay guys, I want to respond to the there can only be one videos. Now, when I think there can only be one system, it's pretty hard because there's just so many of them out there. There's just so many games that you've played on every single system. But for me, if there's one system and there could only be one, now I'm kind of taking a little bit of liberty with it, I guess you could say, because I want to at least make sure what I'm picking is going to be a what I really feel like, and I would pick the Genesis. Now, not this model Genesis, I would pick a Model 2. I don't have a Model 2 laying around, so anyways, Model 2 with the Sega CD added on to it, because Sega CD is just an add-on, plus the 32X add-on, plus the power base converter. Now, why? I feel the Sega Genesis was really one of those machines where there was so much it did and how much it could do that it was almost underrated in the fact. Sega Genesis could play Sega Master System games. Now, granted that I don't know for sure, but I'm pretty sure you could have played the other stuff before the Sega Master System, like the SG-1000. At least I think that's what it's called. I don't know, my brother would know. But aside from that, you got the Sega CD games, which had CD quality sound with them. And then, if that's not enough, you could have the 32X games and 32X CD games. Now, you telling me that's not the coolest thing ever? I played 16, 8-bit, and 32-bit games. Not even the Super Nintendo could say that about itself. So, that in itself is a lot, but I keep thinking, you know, with today's technology, there's a lot more you could do with the Sega Genesis that people haven't either thought of or they just don't think it's worth the time. But here's some things I thought, you know, with today's SD cards and stuff like that, you can have over a gigabyte of memory. So there you go. Instantaneously, you can make a 16-bit game that could practically go on forever with a bunch of graphics and code and all kinds of cool stuff. So you could do that with a Sega Genesis game there, and you could have a really long Sega Genesis game based on the fact that you get almost infinite memory, not to mention the fact that you could use the memory space also for full motion video. Albeit, it probably won't be the best looking full motion video, but you could have loads of it. That's how I look at this, because assuming that it's only the console that stays the same and the technology that could come into later times where it could really be used or something, that's how I look at the Sega Genesis. Because even if we were still playing just CD-based games or CD32X games, you know, 32-bit gaming plus CD quality sound and all that stuff, it's just one of those things that just snowballed with the Genesis, in my opinion. So if I have to pick one, I'm picking the Sega Genesis out of all of them, because in reality, there's just so much that was on the Sega Genesis. And I love the quality of the games that were on the Genesis, because a lot of them came in them plastic boxes, and a lot of them still have the manuals, boxes, covers, and the games itself all in pretty good condition out there. Nintendo never did it. Super Nintendo didn't do it. Nintendo 64 definitely didn't do it. All they had was dust sleeves for the first two set of systems, and then and Nintendo 64 didn't even have them. And, you know, if you're a video game collector, a lot of you guys that collect a lot of games, you're probably collecting a lot of Sega Genesis stuff, because you can still find it in box, in perfect condition, and it still looks the same day you bought it. Or at least whenever who bought it, it still looks that good. So that's why I'm picking the Sega Genesis, because of all the games I could collect, at least a lot of the Sega Genesis stuff is still in its box, still got all the stuff to it. And if you're a collector or even a gamer just having all this stuff from the old days, it's still complete. That's what it is. That's some of the holy grails there to get, is something that's complete in box and still in good condition. So that's why I'm going to pick the Sega Genesis with the Sega CD and the 32X and the power base converter, because let's face it, I want to play 8-bit, I want to play 16-bit, I want to play 32-bit all in one day. I'm not just picking one generation there, I'm picking like three different generations, but it's on the same system. So that's how I look at it, guys. And when I say there can only be one, there can only be one. But it's got to have a bunch of add-ons. Alright, thanks for watching.